Let's pray. Father, in this moment, we need your touch. It's your blessing on Shelia, on the children, on Vernon's mother and sisters. The children that are away from home in Texas and Florida, as we be with them. I pray for this occasion. These are strange times, but you are Lord of the times, God of the seasons. Thank you for Vernon, for his witness for Christ, his love for you, his love for the church, love for his family. Bless, I pray, this moment, in Jesus' name. James Vernon Ellis Jr. was born December 3, 1954 in Tiffin, Georgia. He was preceded in death by his father, James Vernon Ellis Sr. He survived by Shelia, his wife, almost 14 years. He survived by his mother, Betty Ellis, and his sisters, Sandra Colvin and Patty Wynn, and their husbands and families. Vernon loved and was so proud of his daughter, Tiffany Farmer, her husband, Gary, and their two boys, Garrett and Griffin. He loved his son, Chase, and his family, who lived in Texas. Morgan is Chase's wife, and they have four children, Braden, DeVry, Kinsley, and Remy. Vernon also loved Shelia's children like they were his own. He always told his people he had four children, and he did. He loved Karen Mundy and her husband, Shane, and their two daughters, Gwen and Kerrigan, who loved their papa very much, and his lectures. Vernon loved Lindsay Corey and her husband Matt, who lived in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. And when Lindsay met her husband to be, she called her mother and said, "Mom, I found my Vernon. How special. What a testament as to how Vernon treated Shelia." Vernon had a wonderful boss, Reed Bacon, who was a close friend, more like a brother, who loved Reed. And also Alex, his co-worker and good friend. They worked well together. Vernon loved Alex. Reed, would you like to say something?
We were friends for a few. I knew him for 40, 50 years. He's gone through everything. He's a tough guy. I do love him.
Alex?
I can say no more than Vernon will be sorely missed. And we love him, and we're here for him and his family.
Any of the children?
Okay. I wrote down some things I wanted to say because I didn't want to forget anybody, but there's a whole lot more I could say. I met Vernon on May the 22nd, 2005. We dated almost a year, and I thought he was too good to be true. Little did I know that he thought I was too good to be true. He proposed on Valentine's Day of 2006, and we were married on May 6th, which is exactly a month from the day that we would be married 14 years. I'm so thankful that God put us together. We were soulmates. We enjoyed being together, whether it was picking strawberries, watching TV, eating ice cream. We all know how he loved ice cream. He also loved jalapenos pepper, but he was on his own on that one. I couldn't do that. We had lots of fun adventures, from parasailing in Florida, zip lining in Belize, petting stingrays in the Cayman Islands, or my personal favorite, deep sea fishing.
Yeah.
Vernon was the best man I have ever known. He loved the Lord and he lived it. He loved his mother, his children and grandchildren, his friends, his co-workers, his church family, and me. He was optimistic, understanding, thoughtful, kind, honest, funny, hardworking. He always treated people with respect. He gave people the benefit of the doubt and always saw the good in people. He gave second chances over and over and over again. He was generous and helped so many people. He loved teaching the Bible study on Monday nights at Silverdale Jail, saying if it made a difference in just one person's life, it was worth it. I can't say one thing negative about Vernon. Now granted, I did not know him in his wild and crazy days. I heard stories of some of the things he did, and that was not the same man that I knew and loved. God truly changed Vernon's life, and this song reminds me of Vernon's testimony. So please listen to the words.
but the night before Jesus died, he assembled his disciples in an upper room. I've been in that room several times. It has perfect acoustics. And it's a hollowed wall now, it's a hollowed building of sorts. And but I can imagine when our Lord was there at the Last Supper, the scripture says in John 14, Jesus said these words, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again and receive you to myself, that where I am, there you may be also." Thomas, whose surname was Didymus, said, "Lord, we're not sure where you're going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, the life. And no one comes to the Father except through me." Friday morning, we didn't lose Vernon. We know where he is. I've lost things. I lost my wedding ring one time. My wife's never gotten over that. And so apologetic. I've lost a lot of things. Stock market. We've lost all kinds of trillions of dollars because of this coronavirus. We've lost all kinds of things in life. But we didn't lose Vernon. We know where he is. We know where he is. Paul said it this way: to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And because that is true, the moment Vernon took his last breath, cannot imagine the struggle that he had for those days that he was in the hospital. Can't imagine the struggle the families had wondering, not being able to have touched or being able to talk to Vernon. But the moment he took his last breath, closed his eyes in death, the next moment he was in the presence of the Lord. And that is great comfort to us. The scripture says we're to comfort one another with these words. And my prayer for you families and friends is that as you leave this place, you're comforted knowing that our Lord's gone to prepare a place for us. And Vernon is experiencing that right now. Truth is, he's more alive than we are. We still have to pass the bar. We still have to cross this threshold. But Vernon has done that, untimely as it may seem, unwelcomed as it is, unprepared as we all are. It has happened. And know this, Vernon talked about each one of you to me. He was so proud of each one of you. Gary, I had a chance to meet him, Gary. We went to deep sea fishing. How long were we out there, Gary? 12 hours, 2 days, what it was. It was a while, but some of the best days, some of the best moments of my life were that day with you and Vernon. Great experience. And we caught a little fish, and that was always fun. And Vernon had the ability. There are people that you want to know or that you meet that you don't care about meeting again. You know, they light in the room when they leave, you know what I'm talking about? Vernon was the kind of guy that you wanted to be around. You were drawn to him like a moth to a flame. That's a rare, rare quality in people. And particularly, the older you get, the more crotchety you can get. But that's not Vernon. Vernon was softer. He was kind. He never raised his voice. Servant. The fact that he was at Silverdale every Monday night teaching a Bible study to young men. He understood that there was hope in people. That's why he did it. That's why he went there. He loved you. He loved his family. He loved his extended family. And it's my deepest sorrow that the whole family could not assemble today. What a weird experience. You know, the folks in Texas and in Florida and in Georgia know that our prayers, our thoughts are with you, and that we are deeply sorry for your loss. Know that we love Vernon. Good man. Good man. Shelia, thank you. Thank you for the privilege of being here, for taking the risk of allowing us to do this. Don't you all agree? And for insisting that this happen. You're very kind. We love you. Let's pray. Father, bless, I pray now, as we leave this place, with great memories of Vernon Ellis. I ask your blessings on Shelia, upon their children, wherever they may be. I pray for Vernon's mother and sisters, that you be with them, be with Vernon's workmates. I want to thank you for it. I pray that you bless now the time together. I want to thank you, Father, for your wonderful provision. Lord, I want to thank you for Reed and for Alex, for what they've meant to Vernon over these years. I pray you'd comfort now. Let us experience your peace that passes all knowledge and understanding. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
I want to say one more thing.
Okay.
I'm so thankful for the time that Vernon and I had together, and I wish it could have been a lot longer. But like Vernon always prayed, Lord, we don't understand why this is happening, but we know you have a plan, and it's a good one, and we trust you. I rejoice in knowing that Vernon is in heaven, and I know I will see him again.
Yes.
Until then, Vernon has inspired me to live for the Lord. Cherish every moment you have with the ones you love. Help others and be the kind of person he was. And this is from my son Chase and his wife Morgan, who live in Waco, Texas. Their children Braden, Devery, Kinsley, and the new girl, granddaughter Remy, who was born on March the 17th. And I'm so sad that she won't get to know her papa. Oh.
This will conclude the service. We love you to stay. We're always live. We love you to come back after they finish the burial process. But God bless you. Be safe going back home. Be safe in life. God bless you. Thanks for coming.
Thank you, John.
Thank you.